Morning, YouTube. After saying goodbye to our wonderful family friends in Miami, we began the long journey north, starting with Cape Canaveral.
In that building is the real space shuttle Atlantis.
We visited Houston Mission Control in Episode 7. Kennedy Space Center on Cape Canaveral is where the rockets take off. Many missions, from Apollo, which put the first man on the moon, to Elon Musk's SpaceX, have been launched from here.
It has the biggest Grand Canyon in our solar system. Our Grand Canyon's about a mile deep. Guess how deep this Grand Canyon is? 4 miles deep. And it also is the distance of 2,500 miles. Basically, it would stretch from California to New York.
We said goodbye to the Kennedy Space Center and continued north to our Airbnb in Jacksonville, where my host was actually a former neighbor of my grandparents in Mumbai that I hadn't met in years. Praveen recommended I check out the Friendship Fountain and Riverside Park,
where we have a nice little duck pond with actual ducks in it.
Jacksonville is also the eastern terminus of Interstate 10. The western terminus, of course, is Santa Monica. We're about to bid farewell to Florida and enter Georgia. You know you're approaching state lines when you start seeing those truck way stations. Welcome to Georgia. We're glad Georgia is on your mind. We're just glad you're thinking about us.
We just drove a couple of hours down the road and we're at Forsyth Park in Savannah, Georgia.
Shout out to Catherine for suggesting Savannah.
Forsyth Park here in Savannah is surrounded by what's known as the Victorian District, which explains why the architecture is so unique.
I picked these up from the Savannah Candy Kitchen. It's supposed to be one of their specialties, and it tastes just like Mysore Pak, a famous South Indian sweet. Behind me is the Savannah Cotton Exchange. Savannah, at one point in time, used to be the largest cotton seaport in the world, and that legacy lives on in this structure.
So we continued driving up the I-95 and took a quick detour to Charleston in South Carolina. That's right, we're in a new state again. I just looked up some of the top attractions here. One of them is a large fort, which played a huge role in the American Civil War.
Unfortunately, we couldn't catch the Fort Sumter ferry in time, so we visited the Charleston City Market.
It actually reminded me a lot of the Gold Souk in Dubai. Very bustling, a lot of independent salespeople.
It was time to hit the road so we could make it to our overnight halt in Raleigh, North Carolina. Many miles later, we made it to our Airbnb in Raleigh. Feeling refreshed after a good night's sleep, we headed to downtown Raleigh. We visited the North Carolina Capitol, where they had a ballot measure to select the state's official Pokemon. After casting my vote, I drove down to Duke University in Durham, and boy was I in for a shock.
Is full of so much greenery, so many different types of plants, and a lot of mosquitoes. This place is so amazing. You have to stop and remind yourself that this is a university campus.
So we had a good day in the Raleigh-Durham Triangle area. Now we're on our way to the nation's capital, Washington, D.C.
Subscribe for the next episode and click here to watch the previous episode on Miami Beach.